In the 1980s, thousands of people in Central America fleeing violence immigrated to the Washington, D.C. area. Some of these immigrants, along with American health advocates, recognized the unique healthcare needs of this community and founded what would become La Clínica del Pueblo to lower barriers to healthcare and provide community support. Today, La Clínica del Pueblo is an organization that provides medical care to thousands of people each year, many of them immigrants from Central and South America. Most of their patients are also low income and uninsured. In 2020, 84% of their patients had limited English proficiency. They have two main clinic locations in the DC area, a community health action center, and a student support program at a Maryland public high school. The most common conditions La Clínica treats are diabetes, cardiovascular disease, obesity, and HIV, as well as providing preventive care. People can come in if they're sick or to get a regular checkup. Anyone can receive care, from mothers needing prenatal care to the elderly. Most of La Clínica staff is bilingual in English and Spanish, and translation services are available for other languages. Along with primary medical care, they offer programs with longer-term supports, such as Empoderate, which provides LGBTQ+ young adults with things like HIV testing, substance use prevention, and job assistance. Along with their two clinics, they have a program called Mi Refugio at a local public high school, where they provide mental health counseling and mentoring to students who have recently immigrated to the area. Despite the onset of the pandemic, La Clínica del Pueblo was able to continue many of their programs online and treated nearly 4,500 patients in 2020 alone and conducted almost 17,000 telehealth visits for both physical and mental health. La Clínica was also able to set up two COVID-19 testing sites and distributed almost 10,000 masks and other items of personal protective equipment. They also produced infographics and videos to provide accurate and up-to-date information about COVID in Spanish. If you're watching this between February 25th and 27th, don't forget to vote for this video at projectforawesome.com. And don't forget to be awesome!